She was my woman. I love her so.
What up, players? Welcome to the Nasty Soul Channel. Today we're vibing on 1960s and 70s soul guitar styles. We're gonna look at the guitar moves that make up this style and how to take a song from any genre and give it that smooth, Motown-y soul feel. Now, when it comes to covering a song and completely flipping the genre to a Motown feel, the main artist that comes to my mind is Charles Bradley. He covered both Black Sabbath and Nirvana, taking these heavy bands and giving their music a smooth, soulful delivery. Now, his most famous track is Changes by Black Sabbath. And sure, this is probably the softest Black Sabbath song recorded, but just wait until I talk about the Nirvana song that he covers later in this video. Now, Bradley's version of Changes keeps the chords and the vibes, adds some horns in the chorus to really give it that 60s feel, but there's some good guitar ideas to learn from his stripped-down performance with only guitar and vocals. Now, the chords in the verse of Changes are C to D minor. And it kind of sounds like this, just a quick D minor. And this is exactly how it goes in the piano part in the original song, so it fits very nicely to translate over to this soul feel. But to fill it out, the guitar plays a pentatonic line in the bass strings to give the tune a little more feel and rhythm with the absence of all the other strings. Kind of like this. Now, a low pentatonic line like this is reminiscent of the genre, where you would hear one guitar play the chords and the other play a line, like the famous My Girl line. Or in songs like You've Really Got a Hold on Me by Smokey Robinson. So typically, the Motown sound, a lot of it with guitar, is one guitar playing chords, and the other playing a low pentatonic line like that, so it really gives that vibe from the 60s and 70s. Now, halfway through the verse, we land on a D minor and do the simple chord move. So we do our pentatonic line going into it, change it up a little bit so we end on that D minor. And then we take our D minor, all we do is release these three fingers and right back. And that just gives us some simple movement and it stays in the harmonic structure of this D minor chord. And it sounds nice. And right back around. Now heading into the chorus, he does this classic C major move. So we go from this C major chord and slide up to this one right here, which if you think about the cage system, it kind of comes from this G shape, which it's really weird if we play it like this. But most of the time, guitar players will break it up, maybe put our pinky on the root there, but even more so, just start right there with those three strings. Breaking a C major chord up into these moves screams 60s soul. However, this style continued beyond that soul sound and also became known as the signature rhythm style of Jimi Hendrix. So being familiar with these chord moves transcends the genre. Now the chorus goes from F, E minor to D minor, like this. And we can do that same D minor move again. Keeping with this rhythm really quickly. And over the minor chords, we could throw in these moves as well. Over our E minor, we could put our pinky here, or on the B string. And then same thing with the D minor. So just get familiar with those shapes, and you could always throw in those moves over your minor chord just to give it some extra movement, and we could play something like this. All right, let's play through part of the verse and the chorus to see how it all ties together. And just to keep this 60s soul sound going, I'm gonna add some tremolo effect to the guitar. Here we go.
She was my woman. I love her so. But it's too late now, I've let her go.
Okay, so that one's actually pretty straightforward, but how about this Nirvana song, Stay Away? Let's just listen to a bit of that first. Yep, straight grunge. You definitely gotta be creative to make this a soul tune. So let's figure out these chords to start. We have power chords moving pretty quickly from D to B to F to C, like this. Now let's hear how Charles Bradley interpreted this tune.
Monkey see, monkey do. I don't know why.
He basically took out all the chords and just made a one chord vamp in D minor. Now that can definitely work since the chords move so fast in the Nirvana song, it doesn't necessarily have a strong harmonic movement. These weird chords just set the angsty tone of the song. Now when the guitar comes in, it brings the classic soul sound. And the simplest example is doing these staccato stabs on 2 and 4 like this. And you could hear this all over those 60s and 70s soul songs, all of those Motown songs like Come See About Me by the Supremes. Uptight by Stevie Wonder. All on 2 and 4, you go 1, 2, 3, 4. And 2 and 4 is more often than not connecting with that snare, so it brings that out. And you could hear that also on You Can't Hurry Love by the Supremes.
Can't hurry love, no, you just have to wait. She said love don't come easy. It's a game of give and take.
The Marvin Gaye version of Heard It Through the Grapevine. Just listen to that strong, percussive, stabbing guitar part on 2 and 4, accentuating the snare. It's so beautiful, and it's the essence of that soul Motown sound. Now, as we continue along the song, we could do the same idea we did over the minor changes, like this D minor, by releasing these fingers. So I can go 1, 2, 1. As the dynamics gradually raise towards the chorus, the guitar speeds up in rhythm, going from just hitting on beats 2 and 4 to steady eighth notes, very staccato. 1, 2, 3, 4. And when the chorus hits, they match the original chord progression from D minor to B minor to F to C. So basically, if you want to give your song a Motown feel, hit your chords on beats 2 and 4, add a pentatonic line in the lower register of your guitar, and use these chord moves on major and minor. For a major chord right here, we could slide up and play around with these moves. And for a minor chord, we could release these fingers and just do a big bar, alternating between those. Or add or do a hammer-on pull-off move with these parts right here, pinky right there, or right there. Now, just for shits and giggles, let's see if we can give Mr. Brightside by the Killers a Motown vibe.
Coming out of my cage and I've been doing just fine. Gotta be down because I want it all. It started out with a kiss, how did it end up like this? It was only a kiss, it was only a kiss. Now I'm falling asleep and she's calling a cab while he's having a smoke and she's taking a drag. Now they're going to bed and my stomach is sick and it's all in my head, but she's touching his chest. Now he takes off her dress. Now let me go.
Well, there you go. The simple essence of 1960s soul guitar. For interactive tab with this lesson and previous lessons, as well as jam tracks, check us out on Patreon. And of course, keep jamming and stay nasty.